Too Darn Hot, a novel by Sandra Scoppettone, read by Laura Hicks.
If there's anything I don't like, it's a smart crackin' dame. Jack Palance in Panic in the Streets. Chapter 1. Yeah, it was hot enough to fry an egg on the sidewalk. I never could understand why people said that. Did somebody fry one, then eat it? Who'd want to eat a fried egg from the sidewalk, especially in a city like New York? Maybe I'd try it. Not the eating part, the frying. But then people would think I was more of a screwball than they did already. Nah, that wasn't true. Nobody thought I was loose in the upper story. It's just that most people didn't understand why a dame like me would want to be a PI. And it wasn't that I set out to be. It's just the way it turned out. In 1940, Woody Mason hired me as a secretary for his A detective agency. He was a PI. But then in 41, when the Nips hit Pearl Harbor, Woody felt he should do his duty for his country and left me to run the agency. That was 2 years ago, and the war still wasn't over. The office is on 43rd Street between 7th and 8th. A few months ago, the agency moved one flight up, so now I had my own office and a proper waiting room where my secretary, Bertie Ritter, sat. I'd had 2 murders since last spring, solved them both. The first one was prime, and it got a lot of attention in the fish wrappers, so I had a bunch of clients for a while. Just because people saw my name in the paper, they figured I was the best, which I might be. And they hired me for everything, from finding a dog to solving another murder. Not bad for a 26-year-old gal from Newark, New Jersey. Even though the rush was over, my dance card was full at the moment. So when Bertie knocked on my door and said I had a possible client in the outer office, I wasn't overjoyed. Guy or gal?
Gal. She's crying, Faye.
They're always crying.
Don't be a tough tootsie with me. I got your number, you know.
And she did. Always. Bertie kept me honest, like they say. She was the cat's whiskers, far as I was concerned. And she was also whistlebait, a tall blonde with brown eyes that screamed, come get me, even though she wasn't that kind of girl. So, what's her can of peas? I asked.
She didn't give me particulars. I could hardly make out what she was saying through the waterworks. Something about a guy.
What else would it be?
Yeah. So, will you see her?
You know I will. What's her moniker?
Claire Turner. Least I think that's what she said.
Okay, bring her in.
Will do.
Bird?
Yeah?
That dress you're wearing is easy on the eyes. New? She smiled.
Yeah, Pete bought it for me.
Pete? I thought you were gonna dump the bum.
I tried, Faye. We had a Lollapalooza the other night, and when we made up, Pete came round with this getup. What could a girl do?
Well, it suits you to a T. And it did, with the colorful butterflies on white cotton and a diamond cutout below the neck.
Thanks. I better get the Jane waiting out there before she floods the office.
Bertie and Pete had been on and off since I'd known her, which wasn't that long, come to think of it. But she told me they'd been seeing each other for a few years and it was always a battle. Pete wanted to get married and Bertie didn't, which was the source of most of their rhubarbs. In a mo, she was back with Claire Turner. You got your lookers and you got your lookers. This Turner broad was the real thing. She was a long drink of water, maybe 5'9". I knew being just shy of 5'4" sometimes gave me a skewed slant on height, but this was one tall cookie. Her hair was black and wavy, flowing down to her shoulders, and the ends blew a little from the standing fan I had going. She had a body that looked to have perfect measurements, and it was wrapped in a white suit, short padded jacket with a pink blouse underneath. Her eyes were almond-shaped, and that shade of blue close to lavender. Also, they were slightly pink from crying. She had full lips, painted ruby red, and when she spoke, one dimple creased her right cheek. I pegged her to be about 22 or 23.
Miss Quick?
Yeah. I stood up and held out my hand. She took it and gave it a fast squeeze, like she might get typhoid if she held it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.